As with each of the previous 19 campaigns, there was a renewed sense of hope surrounding the 1984 Marshall football season, even more than usual, actually, because of the arrival of Stan Parrish as the team's new head coach. Parrish brought with him a pass-oriented offensive attack, and it wasn't long before that wide-open style became successful. In Marshall's first outing against West Virginia Tech, junior quarterback Carl Foder fired three touchdown passes in a 33-10 victory. The veteran defense also opened the season with a solid performance, recording a safety in the second half and holding Tech to just those 10 points. The Herd's second straight home game was with arch-rival Morehead State. Once again, Air Parrish was in full flight. Foder established a new school record in this game, firing four touchdown passes, including this 66-yard effort to a wide-open Brian Swisher. Later, Foder looks for one of his backs and finds Robert Surratt in the end zone for yet another score. In the second half, a 52-yarder to tight end Timmy Lewis. Combine that with another strong defensive effort, and the Thundering Herd was 2-0 with a 40-6 victory. Game 3 was also played in the friendly confines of Fairfield Stadium. Eastern Michigan was in town to test the Herd's perfect record. Once again, Foder was up to the test, firing two more touchdown passes and taking one in himself for a score. The Herd goes into the conference season with three wins and no losses after the 24-17 victory. The conference opener was also at home, and over 18,000 fans came to watch, second largest crowd in the history of Fairfield Stadium. The task would not be an easy one, as Furman came in as the defending Southern Conference champions. Still, the Herd grabbed a 7-0 lead on a Foder touchdown pass in the first quarter. Then late in the half, the Herd cut into a two-touchdown Paladin advantage with a touchdown pass from Foder to Brian Swisher. 21-14 was the score at halftime. Though the Herd never caught Furman, this game demonstrated the never-say-die attitude, which will eventually pay big dividends for this team at the end of the year. Furman won this one 38-28, but again, Carl Foder was the game's standout performer. He put the ball up 60 times, completing 35 of those for 436 yards, all team single-game records. The Herd's first road trip of the year produced the team's second loss. Western Michigan's Mike Prindell booted an NCAA record 7 field goals as the Broncos bucked the Herd 42-7. Marshall then had a week off to prepare for Appalachian State. And oh, how that preparation paid off, particularly for tailback Robert Surratt. He scored 5 times in Marshall's 35-7 win over the Mountaineers, 4 times on passes from Foder. The longest, this 57-yard pass and run play, which put the Herd up 21-0. Surratt's 5 touchdowns and 30 points established a new Southern Conference record. Meanwhile, the Herd improved its record to 4-2. Then it was back to the road for the Herd as they headed to Charleston, South Carolina to take on the Citadel. Again, the Herd took the early lead, but an interception return for a touchdown put the Dogs on top to stay. Marshall came out on the short end of a 28-17 score and returned home to face perennial conference powerhouse UT Chattanooga. Once again, the Herd held its own against a team which was supposed to be stronger. When Foder hit Robert Surratt with this touchdown pass late in the game, Marshall led 13-10, and it appeared they would knock off the Mocs for the first time ever. But they were stunned on the ensuing kickoff when UTC freshman Jonathan Parker went 93 yards for the game-winning touchdown. Final UTC 17, Marshall 13. After another conference loss on the road, the Herd was in a position where it had to win its final two ball games to finish with a winning record. Both of those games were on the road. They went into Normal, Illinois, where they not only had to battle Illinois State, but also deplorable weather conditions. Defense was the name of the game this day, as the two teams combined for a total of just 13 points. Fortunately, Marshall had the largest percentage of those points. Once again, it was the Foder-Surratt combination which won it for the Herd. They connected on a 31-yard touchdown play to take a 7-0 lead early. Then Kevin Galt provided a little insurance with a 27-yard field goal to put them up 10-3. The stage was set. Marshall was 5-5 with one game left, and the entire season rested on the outcome of that game. The site was the Mini Dome at East Tennessee State. Once again, the Herd broke out to an early lead when Foder scored from 6 yards out. On a later drive, punter Mike Sammons faked the punt and ran for the first down, keeping a Marshall scoring drive alive. Schroeder capped that drive with a touchdown pass to tight end Tim Lewis, and things looked good for the Herd. In the second half, Fodor and Brian Swisher hooked up on an 88-yard scoring play, the longest scoring play of the season for Marshall. And the Herd was in the driver's seat. They led 24-21. The defense made that three-point margin stand up as the Herd won it 31-28, giving Marshall its first winning season since 1965. Stan Parrish did what he set out to do as the team finished with a 6-5 mark. But he didn't do it entirely on his own. Marshall fans came through the turnstiles in droves in 1984. In fact, Marshall led the conference in attendance with an average of 15,300 fans per game. Fodor finished his junior season with impressive statistics, 218 out of 411 for 2,888 yards and 22 touchdowns, all school records. He'll be back next season, as will Parrish, to continue the newly established tradition of wide-open winning football at Marshall.